Drip, drip, drip. Yeah.
Oh, we're back. We're back. We're back. One more time. Jonathan Sanchez. Right here, everybody. We're back. We're back. We're back. That was a dope-ass performance. I want to thank both of them for coming down. This is the point in the show where we like to talk about all the dope sneaker releases of the week, everything that's coming out. That might make some money. That might not make some money, but definitely some fly shit that's worth talking about.
Yes, please.
Right? Before we talk about these sneaker releases, we got to tell the people to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on their post notifications for the Peter Plains YouTube channel, because I can't keep making dope content if you don't watch my dope content. So you need to subscribe, put the post notifications on so you know when I make dope content, which is every Tuesday night from 8 to 9
p.m. Postifications.
Right here. So turn them on. So let's get into the sneaker drops of the week. There's a lot of sneaker drops. The first thing coming out is the newest thing we have from Off-White, which is we just got the 10 is over, right? Yeah. We just saw the MCA Air Force One that's doing thousands of dollars, right? But this is the newest Off-White Nike release. And
Virgil posted a flick with these, with those ladies, right?
Yeah, so it's a Nike Zoom Terra Kyger 5. Tough. It's a running shoe, and it's a women's only running shoe. That's what Virgil's going for. So there's only women's sizes.
Yeah. So, the deal.
Yeah. Size and a half up. Go ahead.
Do what you do.
What do you do? You do size and a half?
Exactly, man. Because they be having the colorways shit like this.
So yeah, I wear 11 and a half in women's. I have like two pairs of women's shoes. They were 11 and a half, and I wear them. I don't fucking care. Yeah. Women's be having dope ass colorways sometimes. Right? The Lady Aquas. Yeah. Right? You can't get Lady Aquas in men's size. That's a fire shoe.
Exactly.
What are you talking about?
Exactly. All
right, so, what are you talking about?
Yeah, what are you talking about? Fire. So we got three colorways. Right? We got We got electric green, we got a black, and then we got the white metallic. Right? How are you feeling? You feeling them?
Yo, I'm feeling every single
electric
one of them.
Really? Yeah, that electric green is fire.
All of them?
They look like they're for hiking.
So he's keeping... It's a running shoe with like little spikes on it, right?
Yeah. And
we have that fat tongue, right? We have that fat off-white tongue that we love to see on a shoe. Yeah. So I like them. I know they're going to do some numbers, but I don't think they're going to do heavy numbers. For sure.
I like the pull string technology personally.
Yeah.
Like
the lacing on these is crazy.
The laces, man. I like that about the Zoom Terror, the whole...
And it doesn't look like an everyday type of shoe, but I can definitely see it.
That's
like
a really fucking comfortable shoe.
You could get a fit off with them for sure because of the colors, right?
Colors are crazy.
Definitely dope collaboration. I'm excited to see them. I don't know how limited they're going to be.
What do we call in the middle? Is that salmon? Oh, no, pink blast.
That's like a hot plane.
But for the men's
version,
I know
there's a sneakers release. There was an early sneakers release. There's going to be an on-time sneakers release. Yeah. But the stores are going to come out, and it's going to be super limited. So we'll see how they do on the resale market. I'm excited to see. Yeah. I'm definitely excited to see.
I'm feeling every
Let's move on.
One.
What do we have after this? So this is a zoomed in version. Yes. I don't know how I feel about the spikes. I think the shoe could have been so dope without the spikes too.
The spikes give it that
off-white flair. That's what he's giving
that
you.
Ninja, that
just
ninja.
Apart from the tag.
I'll tell you one thing. I am in love with the tongue and the green.
The green tag.
Tie.
That's crazy.
Nice touch, right? The dark green.
Taking
zip
it there.
Tie.
Yes.
A nice touch. Moving on.
All right. Come on. We got the CD boy.
There we go. All right, so we got to talk about Stranger Things, right?
That's perfect.
Nike and Stranger Things. We don't have the Nike and Stranger 80s. Things logo? Igor, come on. You're messing up.
Don't.
He's messing up today.
True story.
All right.
True story.
But we got Nike and the Stranger Things collaboration. Stranger Things is a TV show on Netflix, right? It's a pretty big deal.
Yes.
Right? You guys watch Stranger Things? You watch it?
July 4th.
DJ Bud is ready.
Man. July 4th. Get ready.
Soup, tell us about Stranger Things.
Stranger Things is fire, bro.
Yeah, please watch
What do you know
that.
About it? Educate us.
It dropped 2016 July. Like,
very hot.
Like this month, basically. Yes. Type shit. And they've been keeping up with that.
This is season 3.
It's good. Season 2 had 15.8 million views the day it released.
Yo, wow. Crazy.
Wow.
Wild,
crazy.
Right? Here's something even crazier. 361,000 people finished that shit within 24 hours.
Yeah. Wow. It's bingeable. It's just like, if you can just watch them all and you got time, you just get into it. You're like, I'm just going to keep watching.
I finished it in 2 days because that shit was fire, bro.
Yeah, it's hard to stop watching.
Now,
Netflix.
I will say the first season is kind of slow. I know a lot of people don't get into it, but after the third episode, that shit kicks off, and it is crazy after that.
It's Stranger.
Now, the third season is about to drop on July 4th. It's going to be crazy because it's one of Netflix's biggest rated shows.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you know.
Yeah. It does numbers for Netflix.
Season one, it was $6 million episode, like, budget.
Damn.
They kicked it up to $8 million, and now it's up there with, like, you know, most Netflix shows have, like, a $5 million budget. This one has 8 million per episode.
Big fact.
Wow.
So like quick little recap of what Stranger Things is.
What else is coming out with Stranger Things?
Really quick. So it takes place, right? The show takes place.
1980s. The 1980s. Hawkins, Indiana. Yes. Some supernatural shit goes on after this kid named Will gets kidnapped.
But what's key is...
Yo, can I say one thing real quick?
What?
Noah Schnapps, the main character of the show is a sneakerhead.
Oh, dope.
So if you can catch him.
See, here we go.
Yeah, you can catch him on Complex Sneaker
Shop. What's most important is they came out in the 1980s, right? So the show takes place in the 1980s. So they're using shoes that were very popular.
True to era.
So
very
it's a high school, 1980s, some supernatural shit happened. So there's three shoes that they decided to take. Were big shoes that came out in the 1980s. The first one we have is the Blazer High, right? Notoriously came out.
Blazers are fire. I'm wearing Blazers right now.
I have a question.
I never had these though.
Is Stranger Things trap flexible? Is that sound good? Is that trap flexible?
If you talk to me after the show.
Trap flex.
Yes, talk to me after the show.
Okay.
Right, if you got
if you know, you know.
All right. What's up?
So it's called the Hawkins dub, right? So they got the colors, Blazer High. DJ Bud, we feeling it?
Yo, I didn't have these as a kid, but these are nice, you know, it's a clean colorway.
Is this something you'd rock? Would you rock a Stranger Things collab sneaker?
I mean, the shoe doesn't really do it for me.
Yeah.
But if you wanted to really just kind of really support
the
show.
I like the bold orange.
If you want to support the show, you could get off a fit with this real easy.
Facts, yeah,
Miami
yeah.
Hurricanes, yeah. You know what I'm saying? So
if you want to support the show, you could get a fit off.
True story. I seen a kid when I was in eighth grade. He was rocking these shoes.
Yeah.
And he got straight clowned.
That's possible, right?
Yeah, he got roasted. He got roasted, man.
I remember I was -6, and I remember that they were a big deal in the '80s.
I remember these shoes.
When I was -6, these shits was popping.
Yeah.
For sure.
You came up in the Jordan era.
But I would say, dressed off of Stranger Things, this is a collectible.
Yeah, 100%.
It's a collectible.
Let's look at the next one. Another big shoe in the 80s was the Nike Cortez.
Now, boom.
We know we had this. I know you had these.
The Hawkins collaboration. Are we feeling it?
Yeah, the Cortez was better.
100%.
I will say $120 is a very premium price for a Nike Cortez.
Those are smooth. That's -10.
That's a shoe that resonates over time, right?
That was way back.
Nobody can say way bad back. About the Cortez.
-20.
Yeah. Was that right, bud?
I don't like them.
Facts.
It's a lot of excitement. Right.
DOD says that they were that price 20 years ago.
It's a lot of excitement around this shoe, man.
No.
People like the Cortez. All right, we have one more, right? The Tailwind. Right now, that was a sneaker. Smooth.
These ones fire.
Not as popular, but.
Yo, that's hot.
Yeah.
These are fire.
Yeah.
What y'all think? What y'all
them
think?
Joints
y'all
look
is the swoosh extra big, right?
Yeah, I think
so. These look pretty sweet.
Yo, P.
I like the Tailwind and the Blazer, in my opinion. I would probably pass on the Cortez.
You could freak so much. You could even freak Gatorade shit with this.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah,
I would freak the fuck out the Tailwind, bro. I'd freak the Tailwind.
But is the swoosh extra big on these?
One thing's for certain, you gotta be sure. You gotta be confident when you step out.
Oh, with your fit? Yeah, your fit gotta be bulletproof.
Your
fit better be bulletproof.
Yeah, dog. You can't be messing around.
No, this is kind. This is kind. This is nice. You need a throwback University of Miami.
Big facts. Or some dolphin shit.
Some dolphin shit.
Oh. Yeah, big facts. Big facts. All right, what do we have after this?
88.
All right, we got to talk about Yeezys. We have to talk about Yeezys every week. Nobody's going to watch my shit if I don't talk about Yeezys, bro.
The resident Yeezyologist is not with us.
Where's Turnt Up J?
We got a resident Yeezyologist.
He's the one that usually
sees. Shout out Turnt Up J.
Today we're talking about the Yeezy Boost 700.
They're not that bad.
We saw the Wave Runners, one of my favorite shoes of all time. The newest colorway for the 700, not the 700 V2, just the 700, is this utility black, right? All black, very similar to the vintage we got a couple weeks ago with a gum sole.
Yeah.
Be good eye on DJ Bud right over there. I love him having him here.
It's so nice
having DJ Bud here.
Hey,
the gum sole. Are you feeling the gum sole on the shoe though?
It's a nice touch. It's that contrast that really helps that black pop. If I'm comparing it
to the Vantas, bro, the Vantas sat, but I still like the Vantas more.
Bro, yeah. For that price, I get some Pradas.
Some Crocs?
Pradas.
Oh, okay. I thought you said Crocs.
Crocs?
We had to tell a dude in his rap. What did he say last week? If you got Crocs, Stop it.
Yeah, stop it. Stop it, right?
Do I look like I wear Crocs?
I know you don't, man. I was so surprised.
For the utility you black
in the backyard, yeah, you do.
I definitely don't see them selling out. So well, if right, you wake up, answer. You know, have some breakfast, you know, talk to your kids, read the newspaper. You'll still be able to get online, get them without a problem, especially on Yeezy Supply. Maybe they do really well on Adidas, but I'd be surprised to see that happen.
Okay.
Right? That's the show, though. Did you have a good time?
It's not over.
It's over.
Nah.
Well,
man.
We got talking terms after this, so
yeah,
the
so
party continues.
Yeah, hell
the
yeah.
party
yeah.
continues.
The 1-2 punch.
1-2 punch, baby.
Punch. In this screen for everybody watching at home, this show is over.
Yo, right? But facts only. Let me just
are you gonna compliment
recap,
the show?
Recap for the children at home. It's your boy DJ A Boogie.
Gang.
I've been having a fantastic time talking drip live with Peter Plains.
Gang.
Quality Productions.
Gang.
Definitely in the building.
Gang.
Holding it down since day one. So 10 toes down every single time. We talking drip live. This is the only place on earth that this occurs.
I dig it, man. Big shout out to DJ A Boogie. Big shout out to Talking Terms with District Divers. Big shout out to DOD. Big shout out to Stoner Sowell. Big shout out to DJ Bud. Big shout out to Igor. Big shout out to everybody in the building I might have missed. This Talk Drip Live, this was our 31st episode. We'll be back next week for episode 32. Again, I want to say one last time. Everybody needs to like. They need to comment. They need to subscribe. They need to turn on the post notifications.
Like, comment,
so
subscribe.
So I can keep making we amazing fucking content, because if
we
you don't,
the
then I won't make the content.
It comments the video.
They won't have fucking get it.
Please.
Right?
And then they'll hate
it. Subscribe.
But that's the show.
Or it gets the host.
See you guys next week. Talk to your blog. Everybody make some noise. Hey. See you guys next week.